Hi guys, welcome to the first episode of Next Generation BI Guru. Have you ever wondered whether it's possible to view PDFs within PowerBI? Well, you are in for a treat, because the answer is resounding yes, and this is exactly what we're gonna do in this episode. Embedding PDFs within your dashboard can prove extremely useful. You can utilize them as references for some of the metrics you're displaying in your dashboard. Additionally, as we'll explore in this episode, you can create a library of PDFs within PowerBI. This not only facilitates easy navigation, but also simplifies sharing, since all the contents will be stored in one PowerBI file. In the first part of this episode, I'll demonstrate you how to convert a PDF file into a format that can be consumed by PowerBI. Then we'll utilize PDF viewer to visualize them in PowerBI. In the second part of the episode, I'll guide you through automating this process using Python. We'll process a library of PDFs and import them to PowerBI. If you have no prior experience with Python, don't worry, I've got you covered. I'll walk you through the setup process and explain the code for you. Furthermore, I'll share all the contents covered in this episode, including Python code, PowerBI file, and a link in the description. Having that said, there's nothing else to do but to pause this video for a moment, grab a cup of coffee, and let's get started. Okay, here we go. We need to convert a PDF file, one of those PDF files, into a format that can be consumed by PowerBI. So, let's, for example, take this one. The format we need to work with in PowerBI is a binary format that's called Base64. You don't need to know much about it except that this is what the viewer will accept within PowerBI. So let's take one of those. We will use an online tool called Aspos. You can find the link on the top. Also, you'll find it in the references in the description. All you need to do is drag and drop the file and then select from the format, make sure it's Base64 and hit convert. Couple of seconds. Here you go. You have your file ready to download. Click download. It will come as text file. Now we have the Base64 code ready. Let's keep it here. Open Excel. And we're ready to paste it here. You don't want to use the import from data for a reason I'll explain in a minute. Just keep it as is. Go to the text file and copy them all. Select all, Control A, Control C. You have everything selected. And here, paste the text. Once you paste it, you'll notice that it doesn't only come in one cell. It actually covers 15 cells. And the reason why is because we have a limit for the number of characters you can fit in one Excel cell. I think the limit is 32,700 something. So obviously we have character numbers much bigger than this. For this reason, Excel will divide them into 15 cells. Now, if you attempt to do it through data import from here, it will only will cover up to the limit and leave the rest behind. This is something we don't want. We need the whole code to be there. Now, in PowerBI, we don't like this format. We want to convert it to column format because we want to show all of those as one record. For this reason, what we need to do as a next step is, again, go back home, copy, put it in a new sheet, paste, transpose. It will convert the rows into columns and it will fit them in the 15 columns. Now, for simplicity, we'll add the headers here. So let's call it from B0 to B14. Drag this on. That's it. The CSV file is ready. And save it CSV file. Okay, that's it. Now let's move to PowerBI. There's something I like to do to save some time when starting with a new dashboard, is preparing the background somewhere else and have it ready to be imported. So that will save me some time starting with the dashboard. Usually I do it inside PowerPoint. You can match the size of the slide here to your dashboard. from slide size. You can do custom slide size from here, change the pixels as you know. And from PowerBI, you can do the same from the canvas settings. You can also have custom settings here. Make sure they're the same. Back to PowerBI. Save as. Browse. Now, for the format, try not to use PNG or JPEG format, because those formats don't give you very good quality for the background when imported to PowerBI. Use SVG. Save. Just this one. That's it. Going back to PowerBI, we'll go to Canvas Background, Browse, Desktop. You can find the exported slide here. Import it. Make sure the transparency is zero. Fit format. Here you go. You have the background ready. Now, this PDF viewer, you can find it in the marketplace. Just from Get More Visuals. Just type in the search PDF and you'll find this PDF viewer. This is what I usually use. Add it, and here you go. I already imported before. I replaced it and here it is. Now drag it to the canvas. Okay, now we have the PDF viewer imported. The next step is to import the CSV file from Get Data. Text CSV option. Again, go to the desktop. This is the file we created a minute ago. Bring it. We go for transform data. So from transform, we use the first row as headers. That's it. The CSV comes with all the fields, as you see. Now, here's one important thing to do. We need to create a calculated column that will merge all those columns. I know as a first thought, you might think, why don't I do from query editor? But guys, just like Excel, the query editor only accepts 32,700 something in each cell as a number of characters limit. So if you do merge for all those, you will lose all the content except for the first cell. So we need to do it as a calculated column here. And just to make our life a bit easier, instead of creating the calculated column and keep adding fields, we can automate this in Excel with a quick formula. Can say here the name of the column, drag it over. We have all the columns. Then we do one simple formula and drag it over, something like this. Boom. We have our cell ready. Copy, go here, right click, new column, PDF content, paste the formula, hit enter, and your field is ready. Notice here we'll have so many unwanted fields that we're not gonna use. You can also select all of them here, hold the shift, and boom, just hide them. Now we see that they're hidden from here. We have only the calculated column. Just select the PDF viewer, drag it, and that's it. You have your PDF inside PowerBI. This PDF viewer allows you to navigate from one page to another here. If you have many pages, you can navigate from here. Also, it allows you to zoom in and zoom out. If you don't want to see this control here from properties, you can hide the control header. That's it, guys. Here you go. You have your PDF inside PowerBI. Now, let's move to the second part. The first part, we tried to process one PDF file and import it into PowerBI. Now, what if we have so many files? Imagine you have like 100 files sitting in a library in a shared drive. What you want to do, you want to be able to process them all together into PASTE64 format and bring them to PowerBI, right? So this is exactly what we're gonna do in this part. But for the sake of this tutorial, we'll only process those files. Now, the first line of business here is to install Python. Go to python.org downloads And you'll find a download link for the latest version of Python here. Just click it and it comes to your downloads or whatever folder you choose. Double click. Because I have it already installed, I can modify it here. Just keep the default settings, don't try to change anything. This is the development environment where we'll be writing the codes and run them. Just go next and install. Yeah, it's as simple as this. Now you have your Python installed. You can check from the start. Try to open the development environment. Here, you'll find it. That's it, guys. We're ready. Now, let's go to the code itself. I have already prepared the code for you. As I said earlier, you'll find it in the link in the description. So I'll just open the code file. Of course, if you want to start from scratch, you need to use a new file, but I already have it ready. So let's open it. Here it is. And this is our code. I'll go quickly through this code. It's very simple, straightforward, but it does the job. First thing, we need to import few libraries, but don't worry about those libraries. They all are native libraries for Python. So whenever you install Python, they will come with the package. I created a function to be able to call it later. This function will be processing the PDFs with. This function requires two inputs, the directory and the file name for the PDFs. As we go through this function, the first thing, it opens the PDF file from the directory and extract the contents as base64. Then there's another string, strip the code from the binary reference. This is needed because we'll be dividing the code into chunks of 32,000. So we need to make sure whenever we merge them, there's no extra string in the code itself. So don't worry about it. Just make sure to use it. This directory will contain the headers similar to the ones created in the first part from B0 to B14. Also, we added a source to know the name of the PDF we're getting the contents from. Here, we define the output CSV file directory. We'll put the same directory and name it PDFs. This line here creates the CSV file in the directory and add the headers to it. The headers we stored in a dictionary above. And as you can see here, we open the CSV file for writing. The next part starts adding the base64 code into the CSV file. And it opens the CSV file for append. This is to make sure that we don't overwrite the file each time it runs. And we add an iterative function to divide the string into chunks of 32,000 characters and save them and save in different cells. That's it. This is the function. The last part of the code, we call this function and we iterate through the files in the directory and call the function to process the PDF files. Here, we feed in the directory we're gonna use. By the way, remember to add double backslashes to the directory. Otherwise, Python will not understand it as a path. I left a comment. I also commented the whole code for you. And here we iterate through the directory provided above, list all the files, find all the PDFs, and get the file name, then call the function we defined above and process the PDFs there. That's pretty much it. All we have to do now is to run this code. Done. How easy was that? This is the file here, the CSV file. If you open it, just to have a look, you will find it's already created all what we need for us. It added the PDF name and created all the contents in 32,000 chunks. We added 30 fields just in case we have bigger files, but I think we don't need all of that. Maybe here. We used only 26 cells. I deleted the extra ones. We don't need them. And just save. Of course, you don't have to delete them. This is just an extra step. We're done here. Now let's go back to Power BI. Create another page. Just like before, I'll import the background we created in the first part, convert to fit, transparency, move it to zero, and we are ready now to bring the viewer. Now let's get data from the CSV file. Just like before, transform data. And from transfer, use the first row as headers. Here, the code created an extra blank row for us. So let's just remove it. Here you have your data ready, download them. We will use our little trick to create the calculated column. I'll go back to the same Excel sheet we have. We need to drag this to have 25 fields or 26 fields. Right click, new column, PDFs, contents, paste. You have your calculated column ready, and we'll go back to the relationships and hide the unwanted fields. Select all of them, hide, done. Now you have your merged contents ready. Insert it to the PDF viewer. Notice when we added the contents, the viewer doesn't display any of the PDFs because this visual allows you to see one PDF at a time. So what we need to do, we need to have an extra slicer that allows us to navigate through files. Let's have it here. We'll use the source as a slicer field. And that's it. Now you can see all the PDFs came and you can navigate through them easily as expected. And that's pretty much it. As you witnessed, we managed to utilize free tools like the online converter, Python and PowerBI to incorporate PDFs into PowerBI. If you found this episode enjoyable, hit the like button, and if you're new, subscribe to the channel for more unique contents. Also, I highly appreciate your feedback, so please leave a comment. Remember, I included all the contents covered in this episode in a link in the description. Hang on, everyone. This is just the beginning. Now we learned how to print PDFs into PowerBI. Can we actually perform searches on the contents of the PDFs within PowerBI? Sounds promising, doesn't it? Tune in for the next episode to discover more. Although, as a hint, the answer is a resounding yes. Peace.